So, good afternoon everyone. Stormwater is one of the important topic. This is important from two perspectives. One is building and second is infrastructure. Okay. So, there are different formulas for building, different formulas for infrastructure design. We will see in the new course about the complete stormwater, how to design, what are the products and everything. Okay. So stormwater drainage system provides means of conveying rainwater from collection point up to the final drain point. Eventually it has to go to the natural sources. Okay. There are certain codes. So stormwater, there are two parts in the stormwater. One is designing and plan. The second is planning. So planning comes with experience. But designing is always abided by the rules, regulations, codes, standards, law of local land. Material of stormwater. Earlier days, there used to be only channels, excavated channels. If we talk about ancient civilizations, Hadappa, Mohenjo-daro, that time they used to have the bricks. So ancient channels, then as the civilization progressed, pipe came, and pipe was the revolutionary thing. So RCC U-pipe came into picture. RCC is widely used because of the various characteristics and properties of the pipe. It is good in abrasion handling. Whenever there is a flow inside the pipe, abrasion is created because of the flow of the sediments inside the pipe. So, room pipe is good in that. Second, there are categories like NP1, NP2, NP3 categories of the room pipe based on the load class. That further we will see. Now, with modern era technologies and modern era manufacturing processes born of polyethylene, the new pipe like HDP and DWC rigid PVC pipe for external stormwater drainage has been started. So external stormwater pipe has to also cater the load above it. That is also called as abrasion. When the vehicle moves above it, pipe has to withstand that load. What is DWC? Anybody can say? Double wall corner. So double wall corrugated is a very, very recent development. Nowadays it is quite popular because of the its double walls, corrugations. So corrugations helps in proper placing of the pipe. HDP we all know. So what type of HDP here we use? Can anybody tell me? What HDP other application you have seen? Soil and mist. Can we use that for stormwater? That is as per BSEL. What you know mostly, debris manufacturers that is as per BSEL. Wherever this infrastructure stormwater pipe IS-14333, this is drainage grid, and 4984, that is water supply grid. But for 14333 is majorly used for stormwater. Okay, you should be knowing the codes quite deeply, that what which code says what, which code says about pipe, which code says about fitting, which code says about jointing methods, which code says about which is the code which defines the laying of the pipe, installation techniques and everything. So you have to be thorough in that. Okay, otherwise everything is known to the labor class people also. That okay, we have to excavate the trench, we have to put the pipe, we have to do the mirror joints, we have to give the slope. You define the slope on drawings and they give actual slope. So they know few things better than us. So we have to be also better in some part. This topic provides a guideline to collect and capture UIPC 1 2017 source of material. This PPT is prepared based on this code. Stormwater drain requires prohibited connections, subsoil drains, sub drains, sizing of gutters, channels. So all these accessories of the connections is called as stormwater, not only the pipe. Then we can see here by whether stormwater drain which is connecting to the municipal drain and this is outfall to the natural streams. So different. You can see the mat standing on the RCC pipe. This is ancient type of stormwater networks. Trust me, stormwater is a very, very serious business. In the Western countries like Paris, Italy, many cities, it has been found that there was a landslide because of the incorrect design of the stormwater. The stormwater was not connected properly, and because of that, the soil was disrupted over decades, and then there was landslide. So very dangerous if not designed properly. Building drain storm and conductor. The building drain which is covering the stormwater or other drainage, but no sewage. So we have to. It is specific now. It will not carry sewage. There are mixed networks also available. When we see this Mumbai municipal network, they carry sewage, and at the whenever there is a peak stormwater, they carry the stormwater. That is a type of design. That how the city is sitting on to design. If you design the stormwater and sewage, your pipe sizes will be more. So it is better to have different. Then these pipes which carry the stormwater are called as conductors. Scupper, overflow either through wall or cut out or pipe. Downspout, vertical portion, which we call the downtanks. Leader, the exterior drainage pipe of the conveying stormwater from roof to gutter drain. Now we can see pipe scuppers. There is something called as siphonic also, we will cover that as well. Building codes require roof drainage, water not to be permitted to flow over public property, sidewalks and walkways. So whatever, see, you have to one thing you have to be very sure that storm water has to be arrested quickly and drained quickly. We should not allow the storm water to create a layers, okay, which will create a problem and havoc. So this is storm water has should have the nearest outlet to drain off. Roof drainage is also required for all building to prevent roof collapse. So whenever water has the locking attitude or water locks, it deteriorates the structure also. So better to drain it off quickly. Where plugged the drain could allow the rainwater buildup on the roof, separate emergency overflow shall be provided. So now there are, this concept is coming up, normal drain and emergency drain. So whenever there is normal rainfall, it will go through the normal rainwater pipe networks and all. But when there is a huge rainfall, heavy rainfall, usually some emergency network is also given. When the properties are expensive, not on the residential, but like malls, hospitals, where you don't want the rainwater to be stagnated at all. So that is important. In 1-2 family dwelling, it may disturb on the flat areas, drain up. Stormwater shall not be drained into the was intended for sanitary drainage only, as we discussed earlier. All roofs, paved areas, yards, courts shall be drained into the separate stormwater system, into the combined sewer system or the other designated. So as I said earlier, there are combined sewer system. The technical word is combined for storm and sewer. And when it is separate, independent system. So sewer pipe, stormwater drain, catch basins which is collecting the water and taking it up to the infrastructure stormwater networks. Silence please. Expansion joints are required wherever warranted the temperature variation. So you must have seen the building expansion joint or structural joints, where building is allowed to have some tolerance in the swing, swaying, settling. So there, over there, these type of flexible joints are required to be installed. Subsoilers shall be provided around the perimeter of the building having basement, shall be perforated, laid in the gravel, cushioned rock, 18 mm, shall discharge as per the stormwater piping, either by pumping or. So what is subsoil? Whenever the groundwater, is high, usually in case of Mumbai, what happens? The water creates problem on the structure. It is called as pore pressure. Water creates huge pressure, your building can get lifted. So whenever structural engineers are designing, they get the soil survey done. And when they get soil survey done, they identify one important thing: what is the uplift pressure from the soil. Does soil will have automatic uplift pressure? No. When there is a water, the soil is straight to get up there. So structure also has to be such a heavy that it can counter the uplift pressure of the soil. So if the water is very high and the structural engineer is saying that my structure cost is going very high, so at that time what we will do? We will put the subsoil rails, which will be perforated. It is simply a pipe laid along the periphery of the building. At the foundation level preferably, which will arrest the water, it will collect at a sump and there will be a pump which will lift it. What will happen? The uplift pressure will be reduced. So structure will be safe. And nowadays, I have seen when there is a raft slab, the geologists are putting the perforated pipe below the raft. Okay, you put it once and it is for lifetime. You cannot dismantle it, change it, maintain it, you cannot do anything. So subsoil pipe has that function to arrest the water and lift. Then there are, these are the technical things that around the pipe there should be fine gravels, then coarse gravels. Before that, pipe should be wrapped up with the geotextile materials which will not allow the sediments to go inside the pipe. Right? As I said, that collected water, because it is at foundation level, it will be lifted and disposed into the nearest drain. This is the simple thing. These are the subsoil drains. See, these are collecting and lifting the water. Okay, you can see here, this is the way they are putting the subsoil drains. These are the perforated pipes. These can get manufactured based on your separators. So the company is like Prince, Jayabhai is here, he can tell you that what it takes, how the perforated pipe, probably next session he can bring the sample and show it to you. So these perforated pipes are there, they are wrapped up with the geotextile material which will not allow the sediments to go in. Subsoil shall be as per the flow from the subsoil water. It is very difficult to calculate the subsoil water. But then nowadays these geotechnical engineers are there able to identify, and of course as a plumbing engineer we put some tolerance or factor of safety and then we lift. So you can see submersible electrical pump, then there are pipes which will get lifted, perforated pipe which is contributing the subsoil water to this sump. Plinth protection. Subsoil drain also helps in plinth protection. So whenever building has the plinth, plinth beams are very important. Based on that only you construct the walls. Area way drains. So basically all open surface space starts and the entrance to the basement or cellar shall have the, provided with the drain shall be 100 mm diameter minimum, not exceeding 9.3 meter square. So one area of 9.3 meter square can be catered by 100 dia drain outlet. There are other criteria. This is based on some standard rainfall intensity. When rainfall intensity changes, your size changes. Right? primary roof drain. So gravity rainwater system rely on the intensity of rain. As I just said, your rainfall intensity plays important role. How much we consider for Mumbai? Anybody? Yes?
120.
120. 120. 120. 100. 100. What is the unit? mm. This is average rainfall or peak rainfall?
Peak.
Why we are designing for peak? If we design for peak, the sizes will be very high. Why we are designing for peak? Why we are not designing for average?
Average is towards the low and high, so we take it in between. So the sizes will be lesser than that what we are designing at the peak.
But that you just, everybody just said peak?
No, I said average.
It is always peak. There are different criteria for different things. If it is roof, it has to be drain off at peak rainfall intensity. The reason is, the peak rainfall, if it prolongs, your complete roof can get flooded and there will be severe calamity. So your rain, terrace has to be designed for peak. Your external stormwater drain can be designed for some return periods, 2-year return period, 5-year return period, 10-year return period, 100-year return period is a flow. So that gives you the average. Okay? That would be more too technical for this session. So primary, this is exactly what happens when the rainwater falls on the roof and flows into the gutter. So this is what we call it in our local language. This is Khurram, we call it. So what it does, it gets the water accumulated in the local depression and water goes to the external drains. Okay. Or the roof drain. There is a standard how primary and secondary roof drain. As I said earlier, emergency and normal. That can be also termed as primary and secondary. Secondary roof drain or emergency. So I also forgot, so that's why I haven't mentioned it. So secondary is for emergency. So whenever there is a huge rainfall, secondary will take the drain away. The secondary roof drain system shall be separate system of piping. So if it is secondary, it cannot be connected to the primary water network, rainwater pipe. It should have separate, otherwise the whole intent goes up. Okay? It has to cater the emergency stormwater flow. The secondary roof drain system shall be separate. That means that the discharge shall be above grade. Secondary roof drain system shall be sized in accordance with the code based on the rainfall rate for which the primary system is sized. Separate system for stormwater drainage. So you can see this stormwater sanitary, which is waste is connecting to your sanitary sewer network. Rainwater is from the roof, it is connecting to your stormwater. What was the another we discussed? This is separate. Another one was combined. These are the roof drains available nowadays with the many of the manufacturers. Even the Indian manufacturer also has very efficient roof water drains. They have collaborated with many foreign companies. The material is of course cast iron, aluminium, SS, PE, copper, polyethylene, alloy, plastic, HDPE. There are many materials available nowadays. Side outlets, different side outlets. CI roof drain with 100 mm dome strainer. So Swiss strainer just serve the purpose of separating the leaves or some wood particles, okay, or some plastic which is coming via floating to the rainwater. CI flat deck. This is the flat deck. This we can install on the roof. This we can install on the preferably in the car parks. Under deck clamping ring. So different type of installation techniques are there. Test by water or air to prove the water type. So this is the criteria for the testing. So as I said that you guys need to know more things than the executor. So what should be the design testing criteria? So air of 34.5 kilopascal for 15 minutes. We have to detain that, and then you can see whether it is leak proof or not. These are the examples of the tributary areas. Controlled flow roof drain and engineered design and alternative size method to the storm drain utilized for pre-calibrated views of the roof drains to control the flow. So these are the different roof drains. You can say this will allow you to hold some leaves, some sediments. This will allow you to take the sediments. So different methods, equipments are available. Control flow systems, copper overflow. So this is the installation time. This will allow whenever there is a water, once it reaches above certain level, it will allow the water to get in and drain off. Table for ceiling suspended gravity horizontal RWP drain. So this is available, and this you can see basically what it is. Rainwater vertical gravity pipe NVC 2016. So simply, if you want to understand it, simply I will tell it once, so that easy for you to study later on. This is average rate of rainfall. 50, 75, 100, 125, 150, 200. Then 5 tire in ML. And what is this? Area of coverage. So if I have, let us say 100 square meter area with 100 mm rainfall. So approximately here. So I will fall in this category. I have to provide the pipe of 125 mm tire. Approximately. Usually things are not like straightforward. Things are quite complicated, but for your understanding, this is how you can do. This is designing methodology. So Q is equal to CI upon 360 or 3600 based on whatever units you are taking. Mm per hour, area in kilometer square or meter square or hectare. Based on that, this coefficient changes. Whether it is 360, 3.6 or 3600, that changes. So C is coefficient of runoff. I is what? Intensity of rainfall. A is area. And 360 is just a coefficient factor based on what you are considering the units. Based on this, what you can calculate? So there is simply I will just listen to me carefully. We have to identify how much is the runoff, how much volume of water we need to handle, or for how much volume of water we need to provide the storm water drain network. How we can calculate that? Through the rational formula. This is called as rational formula. Very popular. Used in all over the world. Used in many softwares like Bentley, what sewer change. Where there is a model of storm water also, this formula is only used. So what it gives you? It gives you the runoff, volume of water. Then next formula is, which formula is this? Sorry, now it's a Manning formula. 1 upon n r raised to 2 by 3 s raised to half. So we know V equates. Here you find out R, that is volume of water, discharge. Here velocity is equal to. So velocity we know, we limit the velocity. How much is the velocity? Sometimes it is 0.7 meter per second, 0.9 meter per second, 1.2 meter per second. That has to be self-cleansing velocity. So we equate velocity with this, and what we find out? We find out the size of the storm water drain channel. Okay. Calculate the actual velocity. The actual velocity provided is more than the required permissible. So this is a check. There are two checks. q by q and v by v. You must have seen in your fluid mechanics books. So q by q checks gives you whether the section which you have designed is capable of taking that much amount of runoff or not. That is a q by q. What is v by v check? Self cleansing velocity is this much theoretically versus how much you are arriving because of the section you have derived and the slope which you are actually giving. Following is the important design criteria for stormwater design. RWP shall be designed for the maximum rainfall intensity of 60 minute duration. Local IMD data can be reported. Indian Meteorological Department sells you the data of rainfall. Usually you have to develop your own IDF curve, intensity duration frequency curve. Based on that you can find out for different return periods what is the peak rainfall. And based on that, if your property is very expensive, I am designing a bridge and then I have to design the stormwater for the rainfall. What should the criteria I should select? I should select the 100 year return period. That bridge will be there for more than 50 years. So I have to take the peak rainfall occurred in the 100 year. That will be maximum. What is the meaning of 50 year return period? In 100 year, the 50 year return peak will occur twice. Okay? There is another interpretation to this. If your life of your bridge is 100 year and you are taking the peak rainfall of 50 year return period, your bridge will get toppled twice. How many times? Twice. If you are considering the return period of 10 years and your property bridge will be there for 50 years, then your bridge will get submerged at least 5 times. But we design the stormwater network for 2 years, 3 years. When we design it around this building, what is the meaning of it? Your property has to get submerged every 2 years, every 3 years, every 5 years. And you have to live with it. You cannot design it for 100 years. Your construction cost will be on one side, your stormwater drain cost will be on one side. As I said, IDF curves, I explained to you, return period concept also I explained to you, time of concentration, TC, there is a called, this is also TC there, in the IDF curve calculation formula, this is TC is here. So we have to start with the generally 15 minute time of concentration. What is the time of concentration? Amount of rainfall which will be there for 15 minutes. Then you calculate the runoff. So TC is also important. Siphonic roof drains. So, siphonic roof drains are the when we were kids, we used to thief the petrol, or we have to draw the petrol from our friend's motorcycle and put it in our motorcycle. What we used to do? We used to take a pipe, our kids' case, petrol nikalte the, that is the siphonic action. No rocket science. Okay? But it will occur when आपका पाइप का एक एंड जो है दैट हैज टू बी इनसाइड द टैंक व्हिच इज फिल्ड विद पेट्रोल देन यू सक एंड द पेट्रोल विल स्टार्ट फ्लोइंग दिस इज नेचुरल फिनोमेनन दैट इज यूज्ड इन द स्टॉर्म वाटर ड्रेन व्हाई बिकॉज स्टॉर्म इज वेरी इंटेंस नाउअडेज यू हैव टू ड्रेन इट ऑफ क्विकली कॉन्सेप्ट हैज टू बी क्लियर एंड इफ यू हैव टू ड्रेन ऑफ द रूफ क्विकली बट योर रूफ इज सो ह्यूज it's a factory or it's a mall or something, it's so huge, then you have to go for the siphon. Again, secondary criteria, what is it? The normal drain, normal pipe is supposed to get filled either 50% or 75% maximum. Pipe is not expected to flow 100%. If it flows 100%, it will choke. If there is no air, last time we saw example of the pipe, okay? So if there is 100% water and there is no siphonic criteria, your pipe will get choked. Water will not go with efficiently. So siphonic helps your pipe to flow full, okay? And once it flows full, it flows with a huge velocity. The velocity is not there. The pipe literally shakes and that helps you to drain off the roof quickly. So we talk about this siphonic. You see, there is a layer of water which is allowing the siphonic action to happen. Unlike the traditional roof system in which the pipe is flowing partially full, we spoke about it. So technical term is partially full. What Jayanthan mentioned, 50% or 75%, that is partially full. In siphonic system, it operates full. So instead of 100 mm, you might require 60 mm pipe. You save on material. You are better on technology. But then criteria has to fulfill that for siphonic, should have a sufficient roof size which will allow the water layer to create and then it starts siphoning. Now when you design siphoning, it is mandatory to provide the emergency network. In the conventional system, you might skip the emergency network because you size for that. But in siphonic roof drain, you must have the emergency roof networks separate. As I said, conventional outlet is simply a hole in the form of outlet. The siphonic outlet has an anti-vortex plate. This prevents air going in the system, resulting in the full flow. So that has to be fulfilled. Different stages of siphoning. Flow pattern, gravity pattern to plug and flow. So this also we spoke about. That siphonic allows you to gravity also. It is not that siphonic will only siphonically. If there is no sufficient water layer, it will act as a gravity flow, gravity outlet. Eventually, in the third, bubble flow, eventually the storm water intensity increases to the point where the water entering in the system is moving at such a rate that is individual plugs of the water meet, forming a more or less continuous flow but with the air bubbles in the evidence. Hence the term is bubble flow. What is the technical? Last time we spoke, what is the technical term? Why bubble flow? This is turbulent fluid. Reynolds number more than 2000. Now again, somebody may debate 2000 or 10 or something. There are different thought processes about Reynolds number, but 2000 it crosses the turbulent flow from the laminar to turbulent. Full bore flow, that we spoke. Advantages of siphonic roof drain, that I told you already, that it will carry the flow at a very large velocity. Your pipe will be full. This is the second advantage. Okay, so less size carries more water. Okay, and so it acts as gravity. So it is not that the only siphonic will siphonically. So multiple advantages. More efficient. Reduces underground drainage piping, system uses full static head of the gutter bottom to the first connecting drain level. So, this is the way siphonic works and this is the way storm water. So, here mostly we covered drainage, we are focusing on plumbing part. Infrastructure is different because there is a time I would like to add the infrastructure part. So, whenever you design the infrastructure part, now you have the flow from the building. Okay, so that flow from the building, I will take you a little back. When there is a nothing, when the only city is plant, before the city there is a bare shell land. So the runoff coefficient is how much for the land? Anybody? How much would be the runoff coefficient for grass or soil?
0.3.
So somewhere 0.2 to 0.3, 0.4. Okay? So your runoff is less. But when you construct something, when you build a building, what is the runoff coefficient of concrete?
0.3.
So that increases huge, contributes huge to. So when I was designing one of the largest townships, okay? excavated dredge, that is called a dredging of the creek. We did the dredging of the creek, we increases the section of the creek or river which allows the more water to carry. Otherwise what will happen? It will flood. So whenever you are designing the infrastructure, you have to take care of that, not only bare shell land and then 0.3 to 0.4 runoff coefficient and designing. You have to design for the concrete only, because your runoff increases. And when it contributes to the stormwater network, as I said, time of concentration, I will elaborate that also further too. So let us say a 100-acre parcel is there. What we do? We can segregate, or we split that parcel into small areas. So first point, starting of the if the rain falls and there is a header network, basic header network, where all the branches will connect, branches, sub branches, tributaries, sub headers, that will connect to the spine. Let us call it the spine stormwater network. So within 15 to 20 minutes, the first point, first drop of water which is coming into the stormwater network has to go out. That efficient your network should be. Okay, otherwise what will happen? Water locking. And as a stormwater network design engineer, we have to convey this thought to our clients. When there is a huge rainfall, what happens on the road? It gets waterlogged, no? We walk on that. So you cannot control that rainfall, and you cannot design the stormwater network for 100 years peak rainfall. So 26 July, I think 2005, right? That was the peak rain. When the complete city is under submergence, can you design the network for that? No, we cannot design. So you have to convey this as an engineer, that sir, I am designing it for 5 years as per CPHHEO manual or UPC or NBC, and I am designing for 5 years return period. So your property will get flooded every 5 years. Flooded means a 20-story building cannot get flooded, probably up to a floor or half floor. Then there are called something called as flood values. When you design a grade A building, commercial spaces, you have the flood barrier up to the one or two floors. So whenever they have the statistical models, whenever they envisage that there is an increase in the rainfall intensity and there is a prediction that rain is not going to stop, water is going to increase, so that floodgates pops up from the ground, okay, and it restricts the entry of water which is there on the road into your property. So that thing are also available. We are doing it in India. You will also do one day. But you should try to gain more and more knowledge about it. How it works, what is the, how two floodgates can be connected. Floodgate cannot be of 20 meter length. Huh? Floodgate has to be of 5 to 8 meters length, 10 meters length. So how we can connect it. So there are several aspects of the stormwater network designing. Based on roof, type of roof, we are just looking at a flat roof. When there are trusses, king post truss, queen post truss, so when there is a truss, there is a gutter. That gutter is also designed. You cannot just leave it to the wisdom of the labor who is working on that. Okay, haan, theek hai, ek aadha feet ka gutter laga do and it will help. No. So there are many aspects you need to look at. How you are draining off, how you are catering the flow, like that. So, if you want to have any questions, I think we have completed all of our presentation. Feel free to ask questions. We have enough time now. I will little elaborate on this part. how we plan our stormwater network? Based on the road network. Road is a heart. Usually road has a spine road. That terminology I borrowed from the road. There is called as spine road. Spine road is a road which usually connects all other branch roads of that particular development. And it starts from one point and ends at one point, which are the maximum length in that network. So there we put our stormwater network, which connects from the branches and from start to end. So we can say they are our header stormwater branch network, which takes the water from even start of the project and drains at the end of the project. But there can be complications. It is not always possible that start is at the maximum altitude and end is at the lowest altitude. No, that can happen somewhere else. Sometimes the project has crossing of some small river, small creek, anything can be there. So we have to plan it like that. Okay, everyone? Yes,
please. When you talk about siphonation and gravity action, so what happens in siphonation so that the water gets siphoned? Is that the water?
No. I told you, no. You have to draw out the petrol from your friend's bike. What you do? You put a pipe, it stops, and once petrol starts flowing, it keeps flowing, unless there is a petrol in the source. What is the phenomena? That is the phenomena called as siphoning. So it is same, that when you have enough water, where the Kurra or where the rainwater outlet portion is submerged due to the heavy rainfall, then it starts acting as a siphonic. The pipe network is placed in such a way that siphonic starts. If the rainfall is very less, your siphonic outlet will also work as a normal gravity outlet.
But
there is no.
If you reduce the diameter, then in regular gravity time, the water will.
Yeah, but after certain time, when there is rainfall is heavy, it will start flowing siphonically. Like there is no motors or external forces which are applied to draw out the water. That will be a little more problematic for the outlet part. So inlet, I think there is enough capable. Yes, Sarvesh. Difference, I tell you. Channel system will allow the rainwater to get in from any point. If you have the perforated covers, it will allow the rainwater to get in quickly. But if you have pipe, then you must have catch basin. So catch basins are usually placed at 7.5 meter to 10 meter. So you have to give the slope from all the direction to that catch basin. So little difficult for the construction, installation and efficiency perspective, catch basin. But stormwater channel is also construction is safe, easy, because we have, you have to excavate in a proper trench manner, you have to create the walls of the desired size. You can put the aesthetic covers also nowadays. If you don't want to have the perforated covers everywhere, you can put the aesthetic covers which looks good, which are the branding of the project name. So, and there is a technical pipe is considered as the most efficient compared to the channel section. Reverse horseshoe was the most economical and efficient section to drain off anything, stormwater or sewer. But it is nowadays we have, as a city, we have moved ahead. And we don't want that water to be stagnant, contamination, breeding of the mosquitoes. So that way if you look at, then pipe network is the better.
Any more questions asked?
Yeah. Any more questions?
Sir, as you said, for saponic genesis, there is no additional source required to vacuum the pipe to create the saponic action.
System is designed accordingly. So you don't require any additional something to suck the water. You don't require any vacuum or pump to suck the water.
Yeah.
It's a natural process.
So how it is different from normal gravity? Because in that case also, if the stopper will submerge fully, then in that case also,
yes.
So
in normal case, the network of the pipe is not placed like that. In normal case, we take the pipe immediately after the rainwater inlet. Okay, we don't have. Over here, multiple rainwater inlet points are connected to one pipe, which creates a siphonic action. When all get submerged, siphonic starts. If all not get submerged, siphonic will not start. Yes. Because if you design it for that, let us say maximum which is 150 mm per hour, then 150 mm per hour will occur once in a while, maybe once in a complete rain stay. However, if you design it for 75 may occur 20 times, but there is a risk of 150 available. For that you have to provide the emergency. 75 is to work for the norm. So you have to design it, as I said, now there is two parts, planning, experience versus technical installation and design. So once you get more and more experience of that particular region, you will understand whether I should go for 75 mm per hour, 50 or 100. And then you can decide for the emergency. Yeah, emergency happens every year. Okay, 150 mm rainfall intensity happens at least twice or thrice. I will go for emergency. But 100 occurs at least 20-30 times in the 56 days of the rainfall. So I will
design. In that secondary line, so in a marker layout of infra, if you talk about infra area or marker layout, so then till the municipal is promoted there, so how would the secondary line is laid? So a singular line is laid connect to master layout, so to the municipal drain. So what was the secondary drain, how is it?
Again, reframe your question. You can ask in Marathi.
So regular, when we talk about a master layout,
infrastructure
layout, in that scale, regular stormwater drain is connected to the municipal drain.
What is the regular, I do not understand that. What is the regular?
Secondary line is laid in case of emergency.
There are two things. Outside the plot, there is a municipal line, for example. In periphery, you made one common channel. Water comes from the terrace, either conventional or from siphoning, and get connected to the shower. You are talking about that?
So how the secondary line is laid?
I think you are talking two things. Emergency is only for roofs.
Correct.
Emergency is not for infra. Infra is one. It is only for your runoff. It has nothing to do with your peak rainfall intensity, primary network, secondary network, emergency, normal, gravity. No. That is only for building room. Okay?
Okay, so I think we have done with the questions. So thank you, Amit, for a fantastic presentation of our next technical presentation will be given by PTC. They are measuring water solutions that includes water treatment, ETP, effluent, STPs, I think they will